And so the welcome for the athletes in the last event of the night. The men's 4x100, Trinidad Tobago first to come out. They've got a pretty strong team in. Richard Thompson, the silver medalist from Beijing in 2008 in the 100. Andre de Grasse will bring Canada home. Can he get another medal? The follow-on from his bronze in the 100 and his silver in the 200. China will have a great battle against their regional rivals, Japan, in the middle of the field. And the samurai swords coming out for the Japanese. Here's the welcome. And what about Asafa Powell, the former world record holder? 33 years of age. Here's the team from USA. No theatrics there. They just go straight past the camera. We've got a job to do. It'll be Rogers to Gatlin to Gay, the 2007 world champion, to Brumel. Brazil's also getting out there and getting on with it in front of their home crowd, but a moment for them. And the team from Great Britain will be anchored by Adam Jamili. Can he make up for the heartbreak of what happened in the 200 last night? The whole world looks down from up above on Estadio Olimpico for the men's 4x100 metres relay final. There's the lineup. All of the interest, naturally enough, in lane four. Usain Bolt about to bow out of Olympic competition. He's got the only two decided so far here, and he's got the chance of bringing it home in just a few moments' time. They have to get it around safely before he can do that. Bledman to Cirillo, to Callender to Thompson for Trinidad and Tobago in the outside lane. Andre de Grasse will run last for Canada. Akeem Haynes will run first. Brown and Rodney in between. For China, it'll be Tang to Zhe to Su to Zhang. For Japan, Yamagata, Izuka, Kiryu and Cambridge are there for. Here's the Jamaican lineup. The former fastest man of the world, Asafa Powell. He was part of the relay team in Beijing. He'll give it to Yohan Blake, who'll give it to Nicol Ashmeade, who's used to handing over to Usain. USA with a strong, powerful team. Rogers to Gatlin to Gay to Brumel. Here's the Brazilians. They're caught between a rock and a hard place here. They'll be barracking for their team, and they'll be hoping for Usain too. And Great Britain, it'll be Kilty to Akinez Arrieti, to Ellington, to Jamili. The last event on the second last night. Can Jamaica get it safely around to Usain Bolt and let him do the rest? Or will the USA spoil the party? The eyes of the world ready and waiting for less than 40 seconds of mayhem.
Set.
USA got a flying start from lane three. Asafa Powell going well early. Let's keep an eye on the change. Asafa runs a good end to the leg and gets it over nicely to Blake. The change for the USA was good to Gatlin. Down the back straight, Trinidad Tobago leads Canada. Jamaica up to the second change now. They got it to Ashmeade. USA are coming through hard through Gay. It's anyone's race at the top of the lane. Here's the changeover. Ashmeade giving it to Usain. The USA are pressing him. Bolt in front. He's getting to the front now from Japan. And the star of the show does it again. Usain says goodbye to the Olympic Games. Japan gets a surprise silver medal. And the United States have finished third. On the eve of his 30th birthday, the great man says farewell to the Olympics, and we do the same. 9 from 9 over 3 Olympic Games. Japan will celebrate a famous silver medal. They were in it for so long. And the USA have been touched off and they will take the bronze. What an incredible roar from the crowd. Everybody holding their breath to see whether
that we could savour and remember forever. It was a brilliant race to watch because it was still so tight right up until the last changeover. The Americans got that baton into the hand of Justin Gatlin well here. And I think Gatlin closed on the Jamaicans there. He ran a really good second leg there, the man who was crushed by Bolt in the 100 to the extent that he didn't even qualify for the final of the two. Then round that bend, Gay for the United States, Ashmeade for Jamaica, and you already knew at this moment it was over.
And look at him stride away, and what you don't feel in that replay was the atmosphere in the stadium. Japan with the lunge to get the silver in front of the USA and Canada. There's the winning team, Asafa Powell, Yohan Blake, Nicol Ashmeade and Usain Bolt. Another moment in history, but then again, he's created so many of them.
But this is the last, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is it. There will be no more glorious goals for Usain Bolt in the Olympic context. And what a night on which Japan produced their finest sprint relay performance in history. They did it on an evening that they shared with a man who has finally signed off in his own inimitable style. Let's remind you, this is an Olympic journey that began in the heat of the 200 meters in Athens. I went to the stadium specifically to watch him. He would never have dared to dream that 12 years later he would be a 9-time Olympic champion.
Asker Cambridge, who is able to bring them home and get a silver medal that they'll talk about in the land of the rising sun for years to come. Andre de Grasse finished it off well to just miss the medal, but it was all about Usain. That incredible responsibility the other three men carried, they carried it all the way to him, and he says farewell to the Olympic Games, and the inevitable discussions will start happening about Michael Phelps versus Usain Bolt. But they are two different sports people, and this is an event where around about 2,500 to 3,000 athletes compete in every Olympic Games. And that look, the look on their faces tells you they have. What about that? They've completed their lap of honour with the Japanese and the Jamaicans, and now they've had it taken away from them. We can only wait and watch for replays to find out what happened. But Trinidad and Tobago disqualified, the United States disqualified, and Andre de Grasse has got another medal, and the Canadians have got bronze. How about that?
I can't believe it, because it's exactly the same scenario that played out 12 months ago in Beijing at the World Championships. So cruel